Who was the first BBC newsreader to have what you might call a regional accent? Do you know this? It was in the Yorkshire accent, as it goes.
I don't know. I don't know.
I'm trying to remember.
It was during the Second World War. And the idea was people thought, the BBC and the government thought, that a local accent would be harder for a German imposter to put on. Because the newsreaders have to say their name. So they'd say, this is the 6 o'clock news, read by Alva Liddell, or whatever.
And, read by and Wolfgang...
Got you! And the woman would say, this is the 6 o'clock news, read by Wilfred Pickles.
Oh,
yeah, Wilfred Pickles. Unfortunately, the public reported that while they may believe that it was Wilfred Pickles, what they didn't believe was a word he said.
Right.
He didn't speak like this.
This was a lot of fuss about nothing.
So we are winning the war in the Atlantic. No, rubbish. So actors, have this moment. You're an actor as well as a.
I did one stage play
I believe
a while
it was
back.
Romeo and Juliet.
Yes.
And naturally, you played.
I played Juliet, actually. No, it was the point of the point of the play was to create awareness about homosexuality and about AIDS awareness in Pakistan. So we did the play, and the goal was I would play Juliet, and we'd have a man playing Romeo as well. But we did one night, and then we got told not to do any more.
When you say told not to do anymore, is that a euphemism for?
It's not a please don't do anymore. It's not like that at all.
No. Please don't do anymore.
Well, I mean, they don't ever have to point it because it's
because they've got a massive sword.
Yeah, it's implied.
I don't want to make hasty judgments about Pakistan. I've never been, but you've got the Taliban. Hello.
Yeah, but other than them, it's nice.
How do you go Stephen, back? The naan.
Seriously, how do you go back when you do things like this? You stand up for gay rights. You're not a gay man yourself, but you stand up for them, which is completely, unnecessary, but a magnificent thing to do. How do you...
What happens is you get the death threats, and as long as you're getting the death threats...
Oh, we all get death threats, don't we?
Yes. Right. Yeah. But we get them for silly things like, you know, not being ever considered to be the host of a motoring show. You get them for doing really serious humanitarian, against-the-grain political work.
Yeah. It's also stand-up comedy at the end of the day, so you're kind of wondering whether, it's just another penis joke. Like, you don't know how humanitarian it is.
So is there a thriving stand-up circuit?
There was me and another guy.
He's an undercover agent. Yeah.
And he's German, it turns out. The main thing I realised was as long as the death threats are coming, you're safe. It's when they stop coming that means that the people sending the threats are now coming over.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.